What's up, YouTube? Welcome to my channel, Cloud Wine 29, where you discover new wines and escape the clouds. Today, we'll be talking about a very famous wine region and from a very famous country. And we'll be talking about France and the region in Bordeaux. France is very, 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 very popular. It's very famous for all his wine, their wine that they produce. They're like the blueprint for a lot of wine that we drink out here in America, from California, a lot of wine that we drink from Argentina, and then a lot of wine that we drink from other countries. So even if you don't have, never had a French wine before, best believe that the wine that you're drinking probably has some similarities from the French wine. But today we'll be talking about the labels of a French bottle, French wine. We'll be talking about a couple regions. We'll talk about this bottle that I have here. Is from Chateau Les Reuilles. It's a 2018, and it is a Bordeaux. All right. In French, they have about 11 regions. Some of them are Bordeaux, Champagne, Beaujolais, Burgundy, and so on and so forth. There's Loire Valley and others. All right. So it's 11 of them. All right. But specifically, I like Bordeaux. And the reason being, Bordeaux, you get a ton of different type of wine comes from Bordeaux, and it is this tiny small place. All right, on the left side of the water in Bordeaux, most of the wine Cabernet Sauvignon base, meaning like it always has Cabernet Sauvignon, and then on the right side of the water in Bordeaux is Merlot base. All right, Bordeaux, what is it? Bordeaux is pretty much the name of the region where the wine comes from, right? In France and most of Europe, they give the name of the region on the bottle. Like, as you can see here, it doesn't tell you if it's a Cabernet or a Merlot. It just says Bordeaux, all right? But right here, this is a blend of Merlot, Cabernet Sauvignon, and Cabernet Franc, all right? So those three grapes are usually what you will typically find in a Bordeaux blend, all right? A minimum two is going to be two grapes, but for the most part, it will have a Merlot and a Cabernet Sauvignon or a Cab Franc. All right, it'll be a blend of the three. All right, this is a blend of the three. It is 60% Merlot, it is 25% Cabernet Sauvignon, and 15% Cabernet Franc. All right, so Chateau Les Reuilles, Bordeaux, 2018. All right, so this is what most French wine bottles look like. All right, it will most likely have a picture of the chateau, which is the winery. All right, in French they call their winery a chateau. Okay, and then on top most likely will have the name of the country, which is French. Right here it says Produit de France, which means product of France, Chateau Les Reuilles, and then there's a picture of the winery, and it tells you right here in bold letter the region where this wine comes from, and this region is Bordeaux. All right, it also tells you the vintage of this bottle, which is 2018, and at the bottom it gives you the appellation. All right, which is they call it the AOC, which is the appellation d'origine contrôlée. All right, this is where, because in France they control every single wine unless you're part of a separate region that's not part of those noble region in French. All right, maybe you're like one of those mom and pops winery and you just make your own wine, but you're not under the AOC, that specific appellation. All right, and also at the bottom it tells you the name of the owner, which is, this one is Earl Patrick Todesco. All right, they call it the proprietaire, which is the owner of the winery. All right, so this is the 2018 Chateau Les Reuilles. Okay, all right, so another thing too, in France you have Like I said, they have a lot of different regions, and also you have a lot of different variety of grapes. You have Grenache, we have the Merlot, you have the Cabernet Sauvignon, you have the Cabernet Franc, you have the Sauvignon Blanc, you have the Gamay, the Pinot Noir, the Chardonnay, you have the Syrah, you have a whole lot of other grapes out there that come from France that you rarely see in other countries because the production of those grapes doesn't yield to an amazing wine as it does in France, all right? For example, Malbec. Malbec comes from France, you understand me? But the production of Malbec in a country as Argentina produces a way superior wine in Argentina than it would in France because of the climate, because of the soil, and all this other stuff. All right, because if you drink a French Malbec and you drink an Argentinian Malbec, you'll see the difference. It is two totally different type of wine. All right, because of those characteristics, because of the soil, the Mother Nature does this thing. Depending on where the grapes is grown, that region has a specific touch, a specific production, I guess, or it comes out a specific a different way, I guess. All right, so I hope you understand what I'm saying by that. In most French bottles, you will either see the AOP, the IGP, which is the vin de pays, which is like their country wine, or you'll see vin de France. So the appellations on the label will either go as follow, okay? The appellation d'origine contrôlée, or it'll say vin de pays, meaning wine from a countryside, and a vin de France, which is like a general way to say it. This wine just comes from France. It's not under any classification. It's not controlled by anybody, any other wine board. It's just a French that's produced in. It's just a wine that's produced in France, and we're labeling it that way. It's like the bottom shelf will be a wine that says Vin de France, wine of France, and that's it. Nothing else, all right? But for the most part, you'll see the name of the winery, the most likely the picture of the winery, and it'll tell you the appellation or not. And another thing that you'll most likely see on those French bottles are also their classification, meaning whether other than the appellation, you see a classification, whether it is a Bordeaux wine. Yes, it says Bordeaux right here, but also at the bottom it also said this is a Bordeaux classification AOP. All right, and then or it's gonna be a cru, which is two regions in France that has a cru. It is Beaujolais and Artisans. And then also there's a cru classé, which is the top of the top, where you have the Saint-Emilion, the Gravé, those type of popular and very expensive wine, all right? Because those are made a certain way. They're classified. The wine has to age for a certain amount of period. And it gets complicated the higher you go in classification, all right? So we're going to go ahead and open this bottle. Chateau Les Reuilles, this is their 2018, this is a Bordeaux from the right bank, because it is a Merlot base wine, all right? So it is a blend that has a higher percentage of Merlot, so therefore this is an indication that it comes from the right bank of France, because that's where they grow the most Merlot. I'm not saying that they don't grow Merlot elsewhere, but on the right bank is where they grow Merlot. All right, so therefore most Bordeaux that come from the right bank will be a Merlot base wine. All right, we're gonna go ahead and uncork this wine as I'm doing so. So excited to drink it. And those wine this wine that I'm drinking is not an expensive wine, but because it's not an expensive wine doesn't mean that it's not gonna be a wonderful wine. All right, so when you go to France, you're not gonna see 16 million at a restaurant like that where most people go and drink. Those type of wine are not the go-to in a sense, because there are so much more wine that are not popular but also wonderful. You understand what I'm saying? So when you go to France, you will have access to those wine, but you're missing out if you're only going for the Cheval Blanc, the Chablis, and those type of wine. You'll be missing out on those basic regional wines that's part of the AOP appellation. All right, so there you have it. I'm gonna go ahead and pull me a nice little glass. Let me just smell it real quick first. Ooh, dang. Okay. It has a strong smell already. Oh yeah, I could tell this wine will be dry. Oh yeah. It's like an earthy smell to it. All right, the color. It's like a dark red. I won't even say a ruby. It's like more, it has like a reddish, dark red color. It's a 14.5% alcohol. This wine is definitely high in tannins. All right. High in tannin, meaning to high tannin. I get black currant. I get tobacco out of this wine. Yeah, automatically my mouth dries up. I love that feeling. But it's a very rich wine, you know? This wine, needs to be drinking some more. Here we go. And that's what you get from Merlots. Merlots are very bold, all right? This one is very bold. It is not light at all. Medium to high tannins, like high in tannins. I'm getting tobacco notes. I'm getting black currant notes out of this, all right? And those are your basic notes that you would get from a Bordeaux, all right? It's very earthy, like that earthiness to it is great. That comes from the Cabernet Sauvignon, all right? This is definitely nice. I like this Bordeaux by Chateau Les Reuilles. If you ever had this this wine, there you go. Please leave a comment below. Let me know what you thought. And also leave a comment. Let me tell me about what you think about my video and what more I should bring to the video and how else I could dissect the wine for you guys that I've never had. These wine that I bring to my channel. Once again, guys, it's always a pleasure to come here and show my love for the wine to my wine fans and to the world and to everybody else that's trying to get into drinking wine and stuff like that. All right, so leave a comment. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and don't forget to like. Once again, cheers.